All right, for this tip, let's talk about how to generate file hashes in PowerShell. So to do that, I'm going to first just create a text file here, and I'll just call it myfile.txt. It really doesn't matter. And then I'll go ahead and just create it. It's just a simple text file with nothing in it. So to actually generate the hash, I can use the Get-FileHash command in that comes with PowerShell. So whenever I run that, you can see that it produces the hash with a couple properties that tell me how the hash was generated. And one of the great things about Get-FileHash here is really simple. All you have to do is pass the path to the file, and you can even change different algorithms if you want. So you can use the SHA-1 algorithm, the MD5 algorithm. There's a couple triple des algorithms in there. So you can pass any kind of algorithm that you really want to in this instance. So that's just for a single file. You can also do it for a lot of different files. So let's say that I will go ahead and just create one. Oh, looks like it already exists here. So let me just go ahead and delete this out. Well, I don't actually have to do that. Let's keep that in there. So I've already got some files created here. Let me just make sure if it has some files in it. Yep. All right. So it has, looks like all of the length of 2, which means they're pretty much the same. They're blank. All right. So the files are blank. So we can find the hashes for all of these by piping each of those files that get child item returns directly to get file hash. So I will go ahead and run this line. And then now you can see that each of these files is exactly the same. So we were able to generate each of those. So get file hash accepts the file as a pipeline input. So fortunately, that's all you have to do to create a file hash with PowerShell due to that built-in get file hash command.